I was on the ground floor of the development of the cochlear implant and worked closely with my uncle, William House. And what I want to share with you is something that is dear to me, and that is all of the blood, sweat, and tears that he went through in order for us to have a cochlear implant. William House finished his training in 1956 and joined his brother, Howard House, in the practice. It wasn't until 1970, working with an engineer by the name of Jack Urban, that they implanted three patients. And as you know, many developments occurred since then, including multiple channel implants, great electronics. But it wasn't until about 1981 that Bill became very concerned about deaf children. And in the United States at that time, the average diagnosis of a child with deafness was at the age of about 5. And there was nothing that would be done to help them. He knew that the implant might. So he implanted his first child, Tracy, at the age of 24 months. In 18 months, she lost her hearing due to meningitis. She had begun to speak, and as the deafness progressed, she lost her ability to speak. So the first child was then implanted, and she immediately could hear. One of the objections of the first implants was that most patients did not get really true open-set discrimination. And therefore, he was criticized for implanting a child. There were articles in newspapers condemning this as irresponsible. He persisted, and eventually our FDA approved the implant for children. And of course, at this point, the rest is history. We now know that the younger you implant a child, the more apt that child is going to be to develop speech.